Hey guys, Spider Games here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get airdrops by turning in your US government supply requisitions, and I'm also going to show you a couple other things, so stick around. First thing you need to do is locate one of these relay towers. Now, there are five of these located all throughout the map that I know of. However, we are going to this one here. It's called HGB709. And when you get to one of these locations, it's going to be packed with enemies, of course, mostly scorched, but sometimes a combination of scorched and cave crickets. Now, you need to find this computer and then you need to load a holotape. And what we're looking for is the US government supply requisition holotape. Go ahead and activate that, and then you're going to see this screen, request emergency airdrop. You're going to click on that, and then you're going to see this in the top left screen. It says that the airdrop is inbound. Now what you need to do is go on your map, and you're going to see this yellow circle. It says get the supply drop, and then you need to go that circle, and then the airdrop, when it spawns in finally, you will see a cloud of red smoke going up in the air from a flare. It marks exactly where the airdrop is. Now, sometimes it seems like it takes up to 10 minutes for the airdrop to actually land. Like when I was waiting for it, it actually took 15 minutes, but sometimes it's well worth the wait. As you can see, I got a handmade rifle, which is badass. But other times when I got the airdrop, I got just crap loot, like nonsense armor, things that I did not care for. Don't let that dishearten you. You should be finding these all over the place. You find the requisitions on enemies and containers, random spawns, so you should have plenty. But my previous videos, I showed you the locations of power armor, 12 to be exact. In my future video, I plan on showing you even more. But the main power armor that I want to show you how to get is this. It's the excavator armor, also known as the construction armor. But yeah, people really want this armor for some reason. You can't get it till you're level 25, and it's actually quest related. But you need a ton of materials like screws and especially black titanium, which is carried by these mole miners. And they're kind of tough to fight. They can shoot back at you and stuff, but you should have no problem if you're sitting up on a cliff just sniping at them. However, when we were trying to farm this black titanium, these guys kept spawning all around us. We're still in beta phase, so it was really nice. We kept dying though, of course, because of it. Like I said, they're really tough, but yeah, they just kept spawning in. We got all the black titanium. You can see there's no black titanium in their inventory. However, when you actually scrap the items that they carry, like their breathers and like chest plates and things like that, that's actually where the black titanium comes in. But yeah, when you're done, there's just one step after you actually complete construction of your armor. There's one more step to complete in the mission, but I'll cover that in that video. Now, the other thing I want to talk about is the nuke codes. I intend to upload a video on that as soon as I discover exactly how it works. So far, what I know is that you need to find several codes that go to a specific silo. And I recently learned that these codes actually expire. So when you kill one of those ghouls carrying those backpacks that beep, it's usually an officer of some kind, you actually need to hurry up and do something with that code when you loot them, because there's a time limit. Basically, the clock is ticking when it comes to finding these codes. Now, what I'm going to do is, since picking up the code actually causes my map to update, I can see where the nuke site is actually located. I'm going to go to the nuke site, see what's required. Of course, it's going to be high security. I'll probably need a key card. There's probably going to be a quest for that. But I don't know. We'll see what happens there. I'm still working on it. It's a little difficult with it being the beta. We only get, you know, certain times to play. But yeah, that is priority number one next to the power armor. And yeah, my intention is to show you guys the locations and tutorials on how to do all this stuff. And there's more. But guys, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, if you found it informative or you learned something. And hit the subscribe button, because like I said, I intend to show you the locations of every power armor in the game. And I also want to show you guys how to launch a nuke as soon as I learn how it's actually done. But thanks for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next video.